Alright, so what we're going to do here is we're going to put a PT1000 temperature sensor onto our IntelliMax BS Plus controller. As you can see, we've already installed our high temp sensor. We've connected the two little ports to S11 and S12. And now we're going to install a low temp tank sensor in the S2 port. So we're going to put this brown wire on the left. Doesn't really matter which one goes where. And you find a little hole to get your copper end good in there, and then you tighten it down with this screwdriver here. And you want to tighten it down. You don't need to have it have a ton of pressure, but just enough that there's a snug fit and it won't come out. So you have the brown one in, and S23, and now we'll put the white one in S24. Get this up. And tighten this down. You can see we have a little bit of exposed contact. We want to fix that. Take this back out. Push this back up in so it's all the contact areas in there. So just make a firm contact. And there we go. We have our low temp tank sensor installed. We have our high temp collector temperature sensor installed. All right, so the next step after you have your sensors installed is to give the controller some power. This comes with a 3-prong power connector. So we have a live port, a return port, and our neutral. And so we're going to connect this to the controller. Black goes in L20, white goes in N19, and the green goes in 12. So we'll put our neutral in first, slide it in, and get it tight in there so it's good and tight. So we have our neutral attach L next, goes up, and we tighten it down. It's good and tight. Now we have the white goes in there, and we tighten this down. We have it good and tight. And now after we have those in, and we have our sensors installed, we're going to power up our controller. So it's a matter of just simply plugging it in to power strip. And you'll see it turn on. Little blinking lights. It says Woos. It's measuring our collector. Right now, collector is reading 68.3 degrees. If I start putting my hand around it, we'll see the collector temperature increase. Look at that, 70 degrees. So now what we're going to do after we have our controller installed is go through the process of getting it set up. So to start that process, click the little plus button, go across, go keep going over, until we get to time. And when we get to time, we can't go over any farther. We can go left through our menu by hitting the minus button, right by hitting the plus button. When we get to time, we hold down the plus button for a few seconds until it says arrangement, ARR, and has the number for the arrangement that you've chosen. Before you go about programming your controller, you want to know which of the 10 arrangements the IntelliMax BS Plus you're going to choose. And so you click OK, and that has this little set button start blinking, and you can scroll through your different arrangements this way. So you can see the little image changes accordingly to the different arrangements that you select. Well, for our purposes, we'll just do arrangement 1. So click OK, click OK again to save, and we have arrangement 1 set. Now we'll go through and set it up. The first thing, DT0, talks about the temperature differential between the collector array and the tank. We want this to be at 17 degrees, so we'll click OK, set, change this to 17 degrees. The next thing we want to do is change the temperature differential DTF to 5. This means that when the collector temperature is only 5 degrees above the tank temperature, your pump will stop circulating. So we change, click OK, and then change this to 5. Keep going through. DTS is important. The rise is at a certain temperature difference, so in this case 4 degrees, the pump power will increase. So every 4 degrees above the 17 degree temperature differential, this pump will increase its power. It starts off at a minimum of 30%. We can change this so it starts off at 50% when it begins and increases throughout the cycle. SMX, this is your max tank temperature. So we'll click OK. Our tanks can handle a higher degree, so we will set this to 60 degrees, meaning that when your tank reaches 60 degrees, then your system will power down. Let's go through. We have our emergency shutoff, so if our collectors reach 270 degrees, then the pump will stop pumping. This is fine. We aren't going to worry about these functions. And we wanted to test our pump. So if we were to install a pump, the way we have the black power going to L and the white returning to the N, we do the same thing with our pump, having the black go to 18 and the white go to 17. And if you have a ground, it could go to 13. And then you could do the same here. So if we wanted to try out our pump before we actually had our system up and running, we could click OK. And this allows us to turn it to manually on. And this way, right now, you'll see this starts flashing. We have this port automatically sending power to the pump so we can test to make sure our system is running OK. Turn this back to auto. And then we have language set to English and our units in Fahrenheit. If you wanted to change it over to centigrade, just click OK and go over centigrade, but we'll do it in Fahrenheit. And then when you're done setting all the options, you just click the minus button until you get past to time and you're good to go. So now we have our temperatures set, we have our sensors all taken care of, and our collector is ready to rock and roll.